Hey, friends! Did you know that numbers work together just like we do? Well, not exactly like we do. They work together in groups called parts and wholes. Learning about the way numbers work together is going to help us a lot with math problems in the future. Let's get started. That numbers work together, but not quite like people do. There are many different ways numbers can work together, but today we are going to learn about parts and whole. I'll show you an example. I took some of my snap cubes and built a tower. This tower represents the whole, or the total of all of the cubes. Let's count how many cubes are in the whole. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This tower has 10 cubes, which means the whole is 10. How do you think we find out what the parts are? I just need to separate the whole into two parts. It's as simple as this. Now my whole is separated into two parts. Let's find out how many cubes are in each part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cubes in this part, and 1, 2, 3, 4 cubes in this part. So the parts 6 and 4 make up the whole of 10. But how do we know that 6 and 4 really make 10? We can count them all together and double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When we count the parts together, we get the whole. Let me show you another way we can show how these numbers work together. This is called a number bond. With a number bond, we can show how numbers work together in their parts to make a whole. We know that my tower of cubes is made up of 10 cubes in all. That means the whole is 10. What do you think these circles are for? If you guessed parts, you're right. These two circles are for the parts of the whole. When we split my tower, or the whole, into two parts, we ended up with one part made of 6 cubes and one part made up of 4. When we put together our parts, 6 and 4, we got our whole 10. Now I'm wondering, are 6 and 4 the only numbers that will work together to make 10? What do you think? Let's find out. If I put my tower back together, I have my whole of 10 cubes. Next, I need to break it into two parts. This time, I am only going to take one cube off the top. So, one part has 1, and the other part has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This part has 9. Let's count the parts together and make sure that they make the whole. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we are sure that 1 and 9 make our whole 10. Now we know that a whole is made of smaller parts, and parts can be put together to make a whole. I think you're ready to try on your own. Take out your number bond activity from your PDF, a dry erase pocket, and a dry erase marker. Remember, you can pause the video if you need to gather your materials. First, I am going to show you a whole. Then I will break the whole into 2 parts. It'll be your job to complete the number bond by counting and writing in the whole and the parts. Ready? Here we go! Here is my tower made up of 10 cubes total. Go ahead and write the whole on your number bond. Great job! The whole is 10. Look! Now we have 2 parts. Pause the video and count each part. Then complete the number bond. Press play when you are done. This part has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can write a 5 here. This part has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2. We can write this 5 here. Let's count both parts together to make sure it makes our whole 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These 2 parts make the whole. Great job practicing parts and whole. Now we know that parts are smaller pieces we can put together to find the whole. When we count parts together, we get the whole. Remember, in math, we can solve any problem together. You can count on it. See you next time. Hey, hey.